Hey Psych2Go family. Before we get started on today's video, we at Psych2Go wanted to remind you that we're here for you during these crazy times. We hope you stay safe and healthy. We know the coronavirus outbreak must have taken a big hit on everyone, but we'll fight this battle together, and we've got lots of videos to keep you company. Hey Psych2Goers. The coronavirus disease, more specifically COVID-19, is widespread. And negative feelings of fear, anxiety, and worry come along with it. We often hear of important measures to take: stay at home, self-isolate, and practice proper hand-washing techniques. But little is reported about ways to cope with our emotions. We at Psych2Go would love to share 5 ways to manage despair, decreased financial security, increased health anxiety, loneliness, and worry due to the novel coronavirus disease outbreak. 1. Take breaks from the media. With an increasing number of cases and deaths reported in the media, feelings of worry and anxiety can also skyrocket. While it is important to be aware of our circumstances, it's also important to take a step back and do what we can to stay both physically and mentally safe. Urge yourself to disconnect from the media periodically and take time for yourself and your hobbies. You could read a book, draw a picture, learn an instrument, the list goes on. 2. Find out about the measures implemented to support you. People are pessimistic of the future, so markets have plummeted, and most brick-and-mortar businesses are seeing their sales take a plunge. With this comes a decreased sense of financial security. While it is important to budget accordingly, seek information about what the government is doing to support you. For example, the Government of Canada plans to reveal a significant stimulus package to support small businesses and families in this turbulent economic period. 3. Stick to the facts. A common belief is that there is a shortage of toilet paper in Canada, but this is not true. Scenes of frazzled customers stockpiling toilet paper have created an illusion that there's a shortage of essential supplies, causing other people to run in search of toilet paper too. What you are seeing is the effect of a positive feedback loop. In other words, seeing someone else panic makes others panic, which creates even more panic. The World Health Organization addressed other common myths. If you want to check them out, the links are in the description below. 4. Leverage ways of digital connectedness. You are not alone, and you're not the only one who feels the way you do. Many people may find calling, FaceTime, Skype, Discord, WhatsApp, and Facebook useful to stay connected with family and friends, while physically keeping a safe distance away. 5. Know your resources if additional support is needed. A way to combat worry is to plan resources in case additional help is needed. Want to talk to someone? Try Kids Help Phone, vent over tea, or leave a comment below. Psych2Go encourages you to share this post to raise awareness about the importance of taking care of both your body and your mind. Please feel free to contribute your ideas in the comment section below on how you're managing your emotions. Stay healthy and take care. And as always, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.